And some people today they listen to the
lockdown. Yes, 1 minute past midnight on Thursday, there will be a lockdown. The church is not including it. Amen. Amen. So the church is not including it. Okay. The schools are not including it. Supermarkets are not including it. Factories are not including it as well. And also, it's not the pharmacies including it. It is for the bars, it is for the cinemas, for the theaters that were supposed to open on Thursday for the first time, they won't be able to open, okay? And it is for the pubs, the church is not. Let me tell you something, there is no virus in the kingdom of God. There is no virus. There is no virus. There is no virus. Up there, there is no economic problem. Stop talking like everybody. We're not everybody. Say we're not everybody. We're under the grace. Okay? So I would like you to take your offering right now if you want. Bishop, I want to help you with the 10 pounds. Please take somebody with the 10 pounds and give it as an offering. 3 assistants will be here with the bag in Jesus' name. Okay? And Bishop, can I give £100? Please do. Bishop, can I write a check of £1,000? Please do. Bishop, can I give £1,000? Yes, you can. In Jesus' name, yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you should. Yes, you should. Yes, you can. Yes, you should. Yes, you can. Okay? And I appreciate if you can. Okay? The orphanage needs your help. Okay? Just for you to see here, Sister Bianca, I am, I don't forget, I had last week Saturday the test for COVID free, and I'm using my faith. Look at this now. Try to read this in your Spanish mixed with Portuguese. They sent me another one.
Então, nós sabemos aqui que o senhor é um grande conhecedor da lei. Porém, a gente enviou essa mensagem de cobrança identificada na conta do tribunal arbitral. E para todas as pessoas que quando a gente não identifica o pagamento, a gente já envia essa mensagem automaticamente. Tá bom? Por isso que foi enviada.
She was explaining to me that they did not identify the payment, isn't it?
Yes.
And they said to me, we know you are known of the law, but we have not identified the payment. Obviously, we didn't find the whole thing. Okay? And are they right to charge? I think so. But I'm right to defend the kingdom of God, which is the orphanage. And I'll be as hard as I can. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because as the woman of God, I belong to the kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
And in the kingdom, there is no financial problem.
Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So if you want to help, the sisters will pass. And you're going to help in Jesus' name. And I want to make the last prayer for you. But before I make this prayer for you, and thank once again the woman of God in the name of the Lord Jesus for your love and for your care. You know, I would like to say to you, please do support the ministry. Please do. Is there anybody who needs in Jesus' name the envelope of tithe? Sister Gerton and Pastor Errol will give you the envelope of tithe. And I want to go home doing one thing. Amen. If you need Bishop, I want to, in Jesus' name. Okay, I want to just pray for God to give you God's grace. Can I read one more last part of the Bible? In the book of Jude, can you open that Bible, please? Chapter 16. Jude, chapter 16. Amen. If you cannot help financially with the pound, if you cannot help financially with the pound, if you cannot help financially with that 300 pounds, with 1,000 pounds, with 1,000,000 pounds, if you cannot help financially with perhaps any other way, put your knee on the front and pray. Because the prayer of a saint avails much, missionary. The prayer of a saint avails much. That means your prayer can be so sincere for the ministry that God will send somebody who never been to the ministry. God will send somebody that never known the ministry. You see, and then you through that person is helping. If you say to people, listen, this is what the orphanage is, and they rebuke you or curse you or criticize, because they criticize the prime minister. I cannot criticize the prime minister. He thinks he's doing right. Because a blind person, many years ago, missionary, there was a pub here where there is a bar. And this drunk man was being carried by another man. And I saw the man reaching to the drunk man's pockets. And I came to the man and I said, don't do that, sir. It's a man of business. I said, no, you're trying to steal the luggage, the man who is drunk. He just shut up your mouth, man, shut up your mouth. I said, listen, I'll leave it with your conscience. And I went to the drunk man and I said to him, sir, he's trying to take your wallet. He said, you're a liar. I said, me liar? I said, check it. His hand is in your pocket. He said, he's helping me. I said, he's not helping you. He's taking your wallet. He said, get out of here. He was an Irishman. And he just pushed me out. And I said, okay. I'm trying to help you. So sometimes you go to somebody and you say, listen, my church go to this and we have the orphanage, we need to help. He says, oh, this man, and start criticizing. He said, God bless you. Amen. I walked away. Whether the man took the wallet or not, I don't know. But I did my part. Amen?
Amen?
Say, I have to do my part. And one, the best way is if you can sow. But if you cannot sow, Father Almighty, help my church.
Help the man of God who is trying so hard. Give him help.
I fell asleep on my sofa last night. When I realized it was almost 5 o'clock in the morning when I went to bed. You see, but you know I give glory to God.
Amen.
Because I'm under his grace.
Amen.
There was a man called Samson. Have you heard about him?
Yes, Samson.
Samson was brought up in the camp of Israel from a very, a modest family. But God brought him up for a purpose. And the purpose was to defend Israel, was to be a blessing to Israel. Along the way, Samson, you know, did a lot, defeat Israel in many battles. Every time, defeat the Philistines in many battles. Every time the Philistine rises against Israel, Samson defeat them all. And they realize that they could never defeat Samson. Because there was a special anointing upon him. His hair was longer than the hair of Brother Francesco. Look at this. But I'm telling you, it was longer than yours. It caught the attention of everybody. They say, how can we do that? Then Samson one day he was just observing the valley of the Philistine. And he saw a woman. What was the name of that woman? Delilah.
Oh, no.
She was gorgeous. She was over and above any beauty you haven't seen. And he just felt for her. I'm just making it simple. They approached each other. But she was sent. She did not just came up in his life. She was sent to find out where the strength of Samson comes from. You have to be careful because sometimes things, situations, and people are sent. And when you're under the grace, you identify that. Because what is grace? Say, unmerited favor. Say, I do not deserve. I have done nothing to deserve. And there is nothing that I can do to deserve. It was given to me. There is one thing I have to do is to believe in that grace. I'm saved because Jesus died for my salvation. I am blessed because Jesus took upon himself my curse. I'm prosper because Jesus died and upon himself he took my misery. So I am happy because Jesus took upon himself, you know, my unhappiness. I'm saved by the grace.
Amen.
So that's my faith.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't just tell you, sometimes Satan knows that you get into the grace, then he's going to send situations. He's going to send people to gossip, people to hurt you, people to take you out of God's presence, people to make you feel bad. The kids are going back to school. Perhaps there will be a competition. Oh, your trainer is better than my trainers. Oh, your hair is better than my hair. But look at your fat 10 years I'm asleep. Look, you're so ugly, I'm beautiful. So when you are under the grace, those things doesn't matter.
Amen.
Because, say hallelujah.
Amen.
Because it's Jesus.
Amen.
It's the love of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And Samson fell in love for her and began to have a relationship with her. And she came to him and said, Samson, help me. Make you find your strength. And he lied to her. And then come the Philistine and tried to do what she said. And it didn't work. Then she came again. She said, Susan, why'd you lie to me? You don't love me. I care for you. You're within the secret. I want the secret. And then again he said, if you take these boards, and he lied to her. And they came the night and they did what she said. And he
broke it up and got free. And she came and said, you don't really love me because you lied to me again. He said, okay, I'll tell you the truth. My strength comes from here.
If you cut my hair, I'm finished. Well, he could not see. Could he see in the second time? Third time, he couldn't see it again. Because let me tell you something. God's grace is God's eye. Yes. Say hallelujah. You perceive when it is sent by Satan.
Yes.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You perceive that the conversation is leading you to destruction. You perceive that man, that relationship is not of yours. I said in 1995, this lady in Brixton, we will get marriage. I said, really? What you met him? He said, in the supermarket. And she prayed every day. And on 3 months later, there was a request that, praise Lord, take this man out of my life. She was already married. I called her and said, come to church. I was in Brixton. And then she came and she said, well, marry the wrong man. When the Holy Spirit shows you, man, you know, say hallelujah, that you rather be alone than be with the wrong person.
Amen.
Say again.
Amen.
Because in truth, you're never alone. Because the grace of God is in you. You are in Christ. So Samson made a big mistake. Because why did he tell him? Couldn't he see that she was trying to set him up? Couldn't he see that she was trying to take his strength? Couldn't he see that she was trying to destroy him? And they came along him and he was leaping and they died. When they got his hand. Look at this. Big, isn't it? Lord have mercy. How many years again?
One day.
No, how many years, man, you spent to grow this?
10 years.
10 years. Look at this. Cut off. And you know what happened? He realized that he was without strength.
Yes.
Because if they take away from you your faith, you cannot see grace. And if they take away your faith and grace, you're lost. You understand what the devil is trying to do? Say, Satan.
Satan.
Trying to take away
my faith in God.
Did you get used to be home? Life is made by habit. Are you listening to me? If you get the habit to stay home, that is where you stay. You're not going to church. I met a man that he's 89 years old. His wealth is good. And he got married once. And I said, why don't you get married again? He said, I got used to be by myself. That's what he said. He didn't say, I didn't find the right person. He didn't say, I didn't find somebody else. He said, I got used. It's habit. Life is about habit. If you don't be careful, my friend, you become with a habit to have this thing, and then you're going to this, nice dinner, with this thing, and you don't want to take off if you eat.
Yeah.
The dinner is there, you're looking at this. No. Yeah. You have to be careful.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Have to be careful. If he's not for you, he's not for you, he's against you. If she's not for you, she's against you. Don't let people, listen, even if you have just one friend, or two friends, or three friends, but they are true friends, that is good enough.
Amen.
Say hallelujah.
Yeah.
Friends don't want to fight for you, whether in prayer or elsewhere, or somewhere else, or any other way. That man lost his strength. And you know what he did today? One of the most important things that you have apart from your faith and God's grace, okay, which you had lost, is your sight. Because then you can see. If you can see, then you can rebuild. Say hallelujah.
Yeah.
If you lost your faith and God's grace, you can see.
Amen.
You're lost. So he took his eye. He became blind. And every week you could take him, every day you take him for the mocked. And he put them in his arena. I'm finishing. We're late already. So you better get out of here and open. You can even open the kitchen or Valerie. Seriously, because people are going to rush by your party. in Jesus' name, and eat. That man was mocked. They laughed at him. A man that defended Israel. Now Israel was without defense. Now God had to do something else in order to protect his people. And there was. That was a day he prayed. And he made a prayer. And that's the prayer which he made. Can I read it?
Yes.
Chapter 28. Can somebody read it? Chapter 16, verse 28, actually. Verse 28. Can somebody read it for me? I want to hear your voice. Don't read like yours, you know, just read your voice. And I want the assistant pastor to and the members to make sure the young people will come back next week. And don't forget, this week we're going to have the night vigil tomorrow, 8 o'clock. I want you just to know that you don't come to church for Bishop Charles. Say, I don't come to church for Bishop Charles. Enough of Pastor Arrow. You don't come to church for, you know, Ray Vogan. You don't come to church for Jonathan. You come to church for Christ Jesus. Is your eyes have to be. Look at the cross. Say, at the cross. At the cross. Where my sight comes from. That's why you have to see. Don't come to church to look anywhere. Don't look at the nice clothes of mama's eyes. Come to grow church to look at the cross. You never leave church. I gave my life to Christ 9 years old. Got baptized 12 years old. 12 years old. Left the army to serve God when I was 22. Never left the church. For my eyes is set on the cross, and there is no defect on the cross. You might be defectious, not the cross. Say hallelujah. That's why, evangelists, every day I would pay for my friends to take my service at the army for me to be in church on Sunday. Because my eyes is on the cross. That's why there is so much cross here. Because if you look at anyone, you would find defects. But if you look at the cross, there is no mistake there. That is grace. Say hallelujah. At the cross. When I first saw the light and the clarity of my heart rolled away, hey. He was there. I received
hello.
And
now I'm
here today. Verse what? What verse did I say? 28. Can you read from me 28? And Samson unto the Lord. Let's read again. It says like this. And Samson called unto the Lord and said, O Lord, go, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee. Only this one last time, O God, that I may at once avenge to the Philistine. What was his bigger concern? He wants to avenge the Philistine, which everybody were killed in that arena. But he named his army. One of the things that hurt him the most was not even the head, but was the eye.
Yes.
If your eye is good, your life shall be light. If your eye is God, you shall see as God. If your eyes is on the cross, you have no fear. Say hallelujah. Give a mega clap to the Lord Jesus. Perhaps you haven't noticed it. for who was concerned about his house. Don't let anything stop the church, because the day, let me tell you, stop to fellowship with God with your spiritual family. Get up on your feet and say, I am finished if I. Say louder, step out and say, I finish if I give up. If I give up. Oh my God. Raise up, don't listen to the liar. Don't listen to the liar. The liars don't listen. Raise up your hands and say hallelujah. Say, my Lord and my God. Thank you for your evangelist, Andrew, our friend, our pastor. Thank you for all the ministers. Thank you for all the churches. Thank you for this world. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for today. Hallelujah. Give me strength to be here tomorrow. Say louder. Give me strength to be here tomorrow. Raise up your hand and say, and the cross, and the cross. This month is going to be a month of release. This month is going to be a month of joy. This month is going to be a month of good news. This month is going to be a month of grace. This month is going to be a month of breakthrough. This month is going to be a month of open doors. This month is going to be a month of anointing. This month is going to be a month of peace. This month is going to be a month of unfavored marriage. This month is going to be a month of grace. You're going to meet new people that will bless you. You're going to have unexpected miracles. That letter that was taking too long is on the road. That phone call is going to be now this month. You're going to have favor for your boss. You're going to have an agreement and a reach. You're going to be ready to travel next year. You're going to be a giver and a sower. You're going to have over and above. You're going to reap everything you sow. You're going to be a good soul every day of your life. You're going to have an inspiration, good relationship with your family. You're going to have good news and blessings upon your life. Today, tomorrow, and forever. Raise up your hands. Come on, Deaconess. Receive your blessing, the pastors, the assistants. I just want to thank you, 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 thank you. I just want to love you, love you, love you, love you, love you, love you. I just want you, ask you to forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. If I ever said or did anything that upset you, I just want to say to you, I humble myself to say that you are the best of God. Raise your hands. May God bless you. May God shine His face upon you. May God give you peace and joy. May God guard you and protect you. And may God make you to be everything that you have wanted to be. May the destiny come in your life. And may you never fall into the arms of the liar. Say no, the liar. I am a servant of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and all the believers say, give a mega clap to the Lord Jesus. Come on. I want the men to clean up the back of the house. I want everybody to be here 7:33 o'clock tomorrow, and I want you to know that I love with the love of Jesus. Enjoy the rest of your evening, and this month, give me testimony. Amen. Give a hug yourself, say, I love you, Jesus. God bless you. Sing, sing us.
Celebrate Uncle Ray's birthday today. He's 12, amen. Happy birthday, Uncle Ray. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.